Very good morning to all. Welcome to biology video class. In previous video, we have discussed about muscles. That means in chapter 90, we have discussed about muscles, types of muscles, then structure of contractile proteins, and finally, mechanism of muscle contraction. So these all the things we have discussed in previous video classes. So now we have completed chapter 19. So chapter 19, you know, locomotion and movement. So that we have completed. In that, skeletal system is omitted portion. So we did not take that. If we have time after December month, that means definitely we can talk about the skeletal system, don't worry. So in chapter 19 we have about only the muscles. About skeletal system we will see later, don't worry. Now we are going to enter into the new chapter, it is chapter 21. Chapter 21. In chapter 21 we are going to see new system, because in digestion and absorption we have seen that digestive system, and the next circulatory system we have seen, then excretory system we have seen, then muscular system we have seen. So continuously we are seeing that different systems in our body, because different systems makes an organism. Okay, right. I hope you all understood that muscles, structure of muscles, what is the functional structural unit of muscle, that is, you know, I think. The next, contractile proteins, because different proteins, two types of proteins are present in the muscle, that is, you know, I think. The next one about mechanism of muscle contraction, I think it was very interesting topic. I think when you see that particular video, you can know these all the things. Okay, what I am trying to say that please you must watch the videos. I don't know why you don't see that, because teachers taking video classes for you only. So don't escape from the videos. Please, now and then you have to watch. Then after watching videos, please go through the NCERT book, because from the NCERT book only maximum of the neat questions will come. Okay, right. The next one, next we can enter into the new lesson, that is chapter 21. Before starting the lesson, I want to say something. If our body is getting one unwanted microorganisms, example bacteria or virus, whatever it may be, it is invaded in our body. If it is invaded in our body, our body recognizes that some foreign materials which came inside. So what material is this? How can we kill that microorganisms? That like our body will doing some process. So how it is happen? Actually it is what? Regulated by something. Our body internal environment regulated by one system. What I am saying before, if microorganism is entered in our body detect that, then react on those microorganisms. Okay, then it will kill the microorganisms. But do you know that? Yes, without knowing, it is doing. Who is doing? Our body is doing that. It is killing each and every day. It is happening. If it is not happen, definitely each and every one caused by microorganisms, diseases caused by microorganisms, affected by microorganisms. So daily it is happening. So who is regulated? Because in previous chapter and all we have seen that the regulation of excretory system, regulation of circulatory system, that means regulation of heart, that all the things we have seen, because each and every organ is regulated by some system, that is one system. Okay, then another one example I want to say. If you are running very fast, in that time you need more energy, but automatically our body which is produce more energy for that requirement. So some organ, some system which is regulate our body, then apart from that internal temperature, you know, I think our body normal body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. So that 37 degrees Celsius will be constant. How? Who will control the temperature? Who will make a constant in our body? That is nervous system, otherwise known as neural system. Okay, that nervous system only doing these all the process. If microorganism is enter into our body, it is detect and react and kill them. And if you go back, if you go Himalaya or in Arctic region or Antarctic region, then we have so much of cold. If you go there, our body temperature retain. So the same 37 degrees Celsius. How? Because it is regulated by the internal environment, regulated by one system. That system is nervous system. The next one, another one example also we told, if you run very fast, energy we needed. For that, who is giving information to the lungs and heart and to the kidney? Who is giving message? We need more energy. So you have to produce energy like that, giving message. Who is giving? Who is coordinate? That mean nervous system, that mean neural system. So for one action we need many organs. So if you want to produce more energy, that mean the circulatory system is involved, respiratory system is involved, then hormones also involved, so endocrine system also involved in them. So many systems involved in one action. So that all the systems will be coordinated by one system, that is nervous system. So in this lesson we are going to see about the neural system, then human neural system and structure of neuron, types of neuron, and what central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, then how that conduction is happen, impulse, the impulse will be conducted. That means the message is conducted from one place to another place. How it is conducted? Who will create that conduction? That all the things we will see in this lesson. So concentrate on your video. After this class, you have to take photo. When you watch this video, you have to take photo. When you are seeing in laptop, you take the photo and send it to me. When you see in your mobile phone, take screenshot and send it to me. Sir, I have seen or I saw this part. That like each and every students. Okay, I think we have 65 students in biology. So all the one should send the message to me, because in group I will say that. So don't forget that. Okay, right. So the lesson name is neural control. Neural control and coordination. Neural control and coordination. So in this lesson we will see some interesting factor. It is very useful for your studies as well as in your life also. So first we must know about the homeostasis. Homeostasis. Sir, what does mean by homeostasis? The regulation of internal environment of the body. That is homeostasis. So we should regulate the internal environment. Example, I told about temperature. Temperature should be constant. Okay. It should not change. It is constant. Okay. So that regulation done by neural system. Okay. So homeostasis, the way which regulate the internal environment. Okay. The next one. Many systems are regulated by coordinated by neural system. Okay, so what happened? So all the systems coordinated by neural system, then only we can do one process, then only we can do some functions. Without the coordination, we cannot do any functions, any work. Another one example, simply also we can say that when you go in bus or train, whatever it may be, definitely sometimes we will sleep. Okay. So our head, you know, head and our body, which is not coordinated by us, because the head will move back and forth. So it is not coordinated, because while sleeping, the cerebellum is the part of brain that is also will sleep. So our body is not coordinated. Okay, so like that. The next one, here nervous system alone doing the coordination? No. Nervous system as well as endocrine system. So both systems will coordinate. But here The neural system is doing the coordination very fast than the endocrine system. Okay? Because which consists, the neural system consists one specialized cell, it is called it as neuron. It is called it as what? Neuron. Here, the endocrine system, which consists hormones, which secrete hormones. It is chemical. So that chemicals will taken by the blood and it is reach the particular place and it is doing some function. So it will take some time. But here in the neural system, we have a specialized cell neuron which will conduct the message very fast. So it is quick transport system, message transport system. Which one? The neural system. Okay, so the message is known as impulse. Impulse. So that impulse carry very faster than the endocrine system. Okay, right. Then, apart from that, quick coordination also. Quick coordination also given by neuron, but hormones is not giving quick coordination. It will coordinate, but somewhat slowly it is doing their work. Okay, right. Then, next we will see about neural system. As I said before, in the excretory system or in the locomotion and movement also, first we have seen that different organs in different animals. The excretory organ is different in different organisms. Okay, protonephridia, nephridia, and Malpighian tubules and the kidneys. Okay, kidney is the excretory organ for what? Human beings, mammals. Okay, if you take Malpighian tubules, insects. So like that, we have excretory organs, different excretory organs for different animals. In the locomotion also, you see, for locomotory organ, we have limbs, fore limbs, hind limb, the mean legs and hand. But whereas you take in birds, the fore limb modified as a wings. Okay, if you take some insects which possess wings but which do not have what, bones in their wings, but in birds it has wings with bones. So we have different kinds of locomotive organs. If you take fish, it is locomoted by fin. So like that we have. So here also we have, here we don't have different organs, but in the neural system, if you take in invertebrates, it is not well developed. It is not well developed. Example, Hydra you take. Hydra. Network of neuron. Network of neuron is present, but brain is not present. Okay. Because in neural system, main is brain and brainstem, spinal cord, which comes under the nervous system. If you take circulatory system is what? Heart, blood vessels, blood vessels. If you take excretory system, that means kidney, then urinary bladder, then ureter. So we have different organ. So like that, neural system consists brain stem, spinal cord, nerves. Here the brain is not present, but network of neuron is present. By that it can coordinate the body. Then another one. Another band, hydra. Another band, insect. We can take example. Insect. In insect, brain is present.
Peripheral nervous
or neural system. Okay, so the human neural system further divided into two: central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. In central nervous system, we consist brain stem, as well as spinal cord. Actually, here brain stem is act as a bridge between the brain and the spinal cord. So it is not a main organ. But main is brain and the spinal cord. In between that, the bridging is brain stem. Okay. Then in peripheral nervous system, particularly we have only the nerves. So as we said before, in the neural system, we consist of different organs: brain stem, spinal cord, nerves. So it is divided: central nerve, neural system, and peripheral nervous system. Example, we can see that telephone exchange. You know it, telephone exchange. The main telephone exchange is placed in one district. In district one place it is placed. From the main branch, so the wires will be connected to all the houses. Nowadays we have a cell phone, through the tower it is activated, but in previous that, now also even in some home we have a landline phone. That landline phone which will be connected by the wire, but main process, the main control system is in the main branch. So that like the neural system, main branches, main organs are brain stem, spinal cord. From that, cranial nerves and the spinal nerves which is arranged, that act as a wire. So that is carrying the impulses, that mean messages. So the nerves is peripheral nervous system, but central nervous system is main. Okay, it is carrying the impulses, that mean messages. Right. Here nerves is act as a fibers. It is like a fibers. Here we have two types of fibers: afferent fibers and efferent fibers. Afferent fibers and efferent fibers. That afferent fibers, which is connected from the tissues to brain. So that fibers connected from the tissues to brain. The efferent is from the brain to tissues. So that fibers which carry the message, the afferent fibers which carry the message from the tissues to brain. Okay, so some nerves which carry the message from the tissues to brain, some nerves which carry the message from the brain to tissues. Okay, right. Then apart from that, the central neural system and peripheral neural system. So central nervous system is brain and the spinal cord, and peripheral nervous system, if you take peripheral nervous system, which divided into two further. Before that I said what? Which consists nerve, generally consists nerves. What nerves? That mean some nerves which is carrying the message from the tissue to brain, some nerves which carrying the brain tissues. Okay, but here the nervous system, peripheral nervous system, it's further divided into two, that is autonomic, and another one is somatic nervous system. Somatic neural system or nervous system. Okay, somatic and autonomic. Autonomic nervous system. Okay, autonomic nervous system. Okay. This autonomic nervous system, which regulate involuntary actions. Involuntary actions, example can you see? Example is respiration, digestion, and even heartbeat also. Okay, so these process is what? Even urine formation also involuntary actions. Okay, so the respiration, digestion, heartbeat, it is involuntary actions which is controlled by autonomic nervous system. Okay, right. The next, the autonomic nervous system further divided into two. One is sympathetic, and another one is the parasympathetic. The sympathetic nervous system, which increase the pain, the prepare body for action. The parasympathetic calms down the pain, which conserve energy. Okay. So autonomic nervous system, which regulate the involuntary actions, then further it is divided into two. One is sympathetic and parasympathetic. The parasympathetic, the body prepare for action. Okay, example, we can say that if anyone asking to talk in front of 1,000 people or 2,000 people, suddenly what happen in your body will prepare for that particular action. So your heartbeat will be increased, then sweating will be happen. So many things happen, many changes happen in your body. So that is done by parasympathetic nervous system. So your body will be prepared for any actions. If one dog which want to chasing you or which want to bite you, what happen? So are you standing there? No, if it comes there, what you will do? Your body will getting prepared and you go fast and you run fast. Okay, because of sympathetic. But parasympathetic, for sympathetic action we need more energy. Okay, but in the parasympathetic, when you actions happen, if one dog chasing you, I told, it is running behind you, but in one stage it will stop. You are also going far away from the dog and you are standing in one place, and what happened? Breathing out and breathing in happened very fast, and in within 2 minutes or 3 minutes that breathing in, breathing out process will be calmed down. That respiration is calmed down. The heartbeat is calmed down because of parasympathetic. Because of parasympathetic. So constant. It conserves energy, save our energy. But here it could not save our energy. It what? Which is spending the energy. Okay. Then somatic nervous system. It is regulate voluntary actions. Voluntary actions. Okay, the somatic nervous system regulate the voluntary actions. Voluntary actions mean our muscle movements. If you want to take book, or if you want to write, if you want to see, if you want to do anything under your control, that means it is done by somatic neural system. Okay, it is regulated voluntary actions. Okay, next we are going to see that nervous system, which consists of one specialized cell. Already I told that is neuron. So neuron is doing all the process. Okay, so that structure we are going to see. The structure of neuron we will see. Structure of neuron. So in the structure of neuron, we have cell body, that is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm we have. In cytoplasm we have some branches. So this is cell body, which possesses some branches. Then from the cell body, a long tube which is arranged, that is axon. The next, inside the cell body we have a nucleus, then granules are present, that is nasal granules. Next, this is called as myelin sheath. Moses Swanson's are present. So this is called as dendrites, and this is cell body or cytome. This is nucleus. This granules, call it as nestle granules. Next one, this is what? Swan cells. This is myelin sheath. This gap in between the one myelin sheath to another myelin sheath is called as nodes of Randi. This is axon end. Then synaptic knob. Okay, the first one is what? Cell body. Then second one long tube which is present, that is what? Axon. That axon ended with the synaptic nerve. Dendrites, which is connected with muscles or to other neuron. The dendrites, which is processes in the cell body, that means branches either attached with the muscles or it is attached with the another neuron. Because neuron is connected one by one. Okay, the final end of the neuron which is connected with the muscles. Okay, if it is the muscle, which means just you imagine that this is the muscle which attached the dendrites which attach with the muscles, which means if you touch that muscle, that message is carried out by the dendrites to the cell body. In the cell body we have different muscle granules and cell organs, okay, like mitochondria, then Golgi apparatus. Many cell organs are present in the cell body. Same cell organs are present in the cell body, otherwise it is called as cytome. The cell body which continues as an axon, it is long tube, that is covered by Schwann cell. That Schwann cell produce what? Myelin sheath, which develop myelin sheath over the axon. So axon protected by myelin sheath. So the Schwann cell only develops the myelin sheath. The next one, in between the myelin sheath, there we have some gap. So that is called as nodes of Randi. Finally, axon end is present. That synaptic knob is present. The synaptic knob, which is connected with the another dendrites. This is about the structure of neuron. So types of neuron we will see in the next class, because we have different types of neuron. So in next class we will explain about the types of neuron, and then how it is conduct the electrical impulse, okay, from the one neuron to another neuron, and within the neuron how it is transport the messages, that is we will see. Okay, I hope you all understood that structure of neuron, and before that human neural system, and what are all the functions of nervous system, you know, which is coordinate our body, and endocrine system also, which is involved in the coordination. Okay, so I think it is very useful to you. So please concentrate on the videos. Thank you. Thank you very much.